NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 46 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. And we have got a bug on our hands. So, the most recent commit we did the highest and lowest advantage-disadvantage methods, and there is a nasty little bug in here that we need to take care of. I already had the idea of ability to reset whether dice are included or not in our kind of to-do list of things that we're going to do, but it has become the top most urgent thing to address, and I will show you why. So we'll go into the console here. We will use the steps to reproduce. And sure enough, our dice set total is zero. Because if we look at our dice, all of them have included in the total equal to false. And if you do this enough times with the combination of the highest or lowest method with reroll all, so we've got reroll all here, we've got the highest lowest methods here, it will eventually, because there's nothing resetting the whether the die is included in the total or not, that will eventually all become false if you do those two methods together over and over again. So we've got to fix that. We'll move this into in progress, and the way we're going to fix it is by the ability to reset whether dice are included in the total or not. So we'll start by creating our spec here. Describe the include all dice method. It changes total, I believe. Yes. Or do true for all dice. We will use just our standard dice set here. So we'll create the opposite situation here. Do each to use similar to our to all b. Maybe that was in. Refactor it after RuboCop gets angry at us, but we will expect die dot included in total to not the most elegant spec ever, but it fails. So we'll move our so we're back to passing. Now we need to make sure that this is called at the beginning of highest and lowest methods. Still passing. Now let's take our steps to reproduce. See if they still reproduce our issue. Now we've got a total of 12. So we've got a 3, a 4, a 5, and a 5. We went with highest 3, but re-rolled afterwards. So now if we do this, now we've got a 14, so 5, 5, and 4, which is what we expect. Make sure our code coverage is not degraded. We shall submit to the civil authorities. And I'm going to make this its own commit since it has an issue. associated with it. So. Commit. Write the message. So I've got my commit message. I'll sign it. And we'll push that. So while we're waiting for these items, comment on this one. So this is done. Passed. So we can say that future die object close with comment. Go back to our project, move that to done. All right, and the next thing we're going to do is create a setter method for the DiceSet bonus. So we'll take a look at that. Right now, DiceSet, we have bonus as an attribute reader, but we do not have a bonus equals method. So you can see here there's the begin rescue end there that we can just pull out of that parse options and make a bonus equals method. So we'll go in and create a another describe block. I don't know why I couldn't talk, but it happens sometimes. All right, so describe set the bonus. And then it errors out if you provide invalid input. We'll go back to our flump example. So we'll do this one first. Right now it'll raise an error, but it'll raise a no method error. And then equals 14 will be high level this time. And then pretty boring. It's a attribute writer, but it does have the ability to raise an error, so we'll write specs for it. We've got two failures. Yeah, so we're getting a no method error. We will write our bonus equals method. Put it right under randomization technique. And it's going to be I, it'll rescue and it will raise. That's passing. Now we're going to go back in and use this in the constructor. We're calling 2i on it in the method there, so we don't have to do it in the parse options method. That works. Our coverage remains stable. The road pirates are not happy. Redundant block and empty lines. All right, so we'll just let those autocorrect. So I don't need the begin rescue there if I do it in the def method. So that is more elegant. No offenses remain. Our specs still pass. And I think we can commit what we have. Commit message. So we've got our message, we'll sign the commit, push to the branch, go back over to GitHub, move this to done, actions to complete. And there we have it. We'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.